This here is another viewer's broken gaming PC, and this one apparently doesn't post. I'm told by the owner that it's probably a CPU issue. Kind of odd that he's so specific on that. Usually folks that send stuff to me, they have no idea. But this owner seems to be pretty dead set on it being a CPU problem. That might influence my troubleshooting steps that you see in this one. We'll still run through the general things that we always do in the beginning, but who knows? Could be anything, and hopefully by the end of this one, we can have it back up and running for him. Are you ready? You know what's coming next. Stay with me.
NZXT's H7 series cases offer plenty of hardware support and a clean aesthetic sure to complement any build. Choose between white or black variants, as well as standard, flow, or elite trims for the right mixture of airflow and beauty. There's plenty of room up top for a fan rad combo larger than just a single 120 or 140, and support for up to a 360mm up front exists for beefy cooling wherever it's needed. You'll also find several fans included depending on the model. If you choose the white one, you'll get white fans, so that's nice. NZXT cases are overall great values, as you'll find, and you can learn more about them by clicking the link below.
Hello everyone, and welcome to another episode of Fix or Flop. In this playlist, we attempt to fix viewers' computers in and around Orlando, Florida, for free. We charge nothing for the service, and as a result of that, folks have been actually pretty cool about driving out to meet me. That's kind of the trade-off here, especially with gas prices being as high as they are now. It's not easy to just drive across the city, especially in Orlando traffic at rush hour, to drop off a system for somebody. So the fact that we don't charge at all, I think, offsets that. It's nice. It allows us to continue making videos like these. This is how we make our money. We monetize these videos. We have sponsors in these as well. And so as a result, I don't offload any of that implied cost to the viewers. We're already gracious enough to loan us our systems for a few days. I don't know too much about the system specifications apart from the obvious. The graphics card is an SFX RX 580 8GB. And of course, a Ryzen platform, so some sort of Ryzen CPU in here, a Tomahawk Max motherboard from MSI, and the stock Wraith cooler. The case here is from Fantex. I think this is the P350, if I recall correctly. I'd have to go back and look. The build overall is a bit dusty, a bit dirty, but that's not what we're tasked with in this one. We're not going to deep clean it. We're going to try to fix it. So with that out of the way, let's get straight into the troubleshooting process. You guys know by this point what we need to do is attempt to power the system on and replicate the issue described by the owner. In this case, either a no post or no power scenario. Portable monitor. Check. HDMI cable. Check. Power supply switch. Check. And let's see what we've got going here. This button's a little stuck, but it doesn't seem to want to fire up. Okay, let's try to jump the system manually with a screwdriver. Sheesh, still nothing. The only reason I checked this first is because, yeah, like I said, the power button's a bit sticky. The 8-pin EPS up top looks good. 24, ooh, you know what? His 24 pin's not slotted in all the way. Not sure how well you'll be able to see this from your vantage point, but you can see that little gap right there. If you can, that shouldn't be there. You should be able to push this all the way in like that. Now, I bet we can get some power. I'm just gonna jump straight into another power on attempt because that very well could be explaining what we were seeing. Well, that worked for like a split second. Let's try again. Oh man, really? Power cycle completely. Nothing. We had power for like a fraction of a second and now it's gone. Okay, so it wasn't just the 24 pin. Now you'll notice as I attempt to clear the CMOS here, after holding this down for, I'll just blink there, hold this for a few seconds, and then I'll remove my tool, and it'll just flash for a split second, and I notice on the debug LEDs above the 24 pin that the CPU light lights up for just a fraction of a second again, and everything shuts back off. This very well could be a CPU issue. Could also be a power supply issue. Those are the two things off the top that I think we're gonna dive deeper into first. I doubt the card is keeping the system from posting. Usually if it's a card issue, the remainder of the system will still power on. The 24 pin and the 8 pin up top are connected. We've got everything else disconnected, so non-vitals are no longer in play here. I forgot to disconnect this extra USB cable. Let's try again. Yeah, still no power. And if we attempt to clear CMOS again, we just get that quick flash. So yeah, let's dive a bit deeper. We've got our Passmark inline PSU tester here. I know the camera has things a bit dark just so you can read the screen. So we're gonna hold down the power button. That should turn the PSU on. And we're just gonna check for, let's see. Yeah, everything looks good. We're also getting LEDs. I've got the other stuff connected, the Molex and SATA, to the things in his rig. I can see that there are some lights powered on below, so everything here looks good. There is an issue for sure with his platform. By the way, yeah, that's a spider web. Not sure if the camera's focusing on it. This is why the wife absolutely loves what I do for work. This isn't normally the first place I would start, but like I said, I've got reason to believe the CPU is the problem here. Maybe the viewer knows something that he's not telling me. It definitely looks like a platform problem though. Let's remove this cooler and see what CPU we're working with. This could potentially be a BIOS incompatibility issue, although this being a Max motherboard, I doubt that's the case. Still worth checking though. We also might have, gonna give this just a bit of a wiggle, we also might have an issue with either the pins on the chip or the socket, which we've run into in the past. There we go. And let's see. Ah, very interesting. Throwing it back just a tad, a Ryzen 7 1800X. Now on the underside of the chip, I don't see any missing pins. There are no bent pins either. Actually looks really good back here. There's a bit of overbleeding thermal paste. I cleaned that up for him, so the chip looks basically brand new again. But I'd be ashamed if this was the reason why I wasn't posting. I think what I'm gonna do is swap this out for a known working chip that I have, and we'll try our luck there. I have here a Ryzen 7 1700X, which is very close to his 1800X, same generation at least, same core count and everything, so this is as apples to apples as we can get given what I have on hand. We'll put this in the rig and we'll fire it up. I've actually got all of his regular components connected to this makeshift test bench. The only change, again, is that CPU. I don't suspect anything else is wrong with his rig, which is why I'm doing things this way. So let's make sure the power supply is powered on, and we'll jump to power pins. It just did it again. It just cut in and out again. So it's not a CPU. Wow. It's probably the motherboard. I can't believe it's there's no way it's the card. That's the only other thing here that we haven't tried that I would think would be obvious by this point, given the symptoms we're seeing. We'll check just to be on the safe side. I'll swap in my GT710 just to get it out of the way before we swap the motherboard, because that's the most labor-intensive process of all of this. And we only want to do that if we absolutely have to. In she goes. And in one continuous shot here, we'll go ahead and try powering on as well. So switch at the rear and power pins. No way! What? No way! I can't believe it was the card! Oh, I've never seen a graphics card do that before. The system is fired up. We have no LED debug lights indicated on the board, so we should be getting a post any second now. Okay, this isn't what I had in mind. So at this point, I'm suspecting the motherboard. I mean, what else could it be if my GT710 that always works is not working? Then I think the board needs to be replaced. I guess that's better than the CPU. I don't know which one's worse at this point. One thing that I am going to try though before swapping it out is updating the BIOS, and we can do that with this board because this has a flash BIOS function that does not require a compatible CPU already be present in the socket. So that's what's happening now, I think. Pretty sure I did that right. And once this is fully updated, the system should restart. And then maybe, just maybe, we'll get a post. We'll try. Well, I'm not sure if this is an improvement or not, but the system is now displaying the CPU debug LED permanently. It's just always on. If I can get it to focus, there it goes. And the LEDs behind the motherboard have also changed. They're no longer red, they're like a bluish color. So, yeah, I mean, we still don't have a post, so there's that. Without system RAM, I can trick it into displaying the DRAM LED instead of the CPU light. I think it'll pivot back to the CPU though at some point here. Nope. Still staying on DRAM. Okay, so that's weird. You know what? Maybe we'll try reflashing this BIOS one more time. Yeah, that didn't do anything. So I think before I keep giving this motherboard chances that I shouldn't be. I'm gonna try my 5700G here, and I'm using this specifically because swapping out the graphics card at least got us a bit further. Although I have no reason to think his card is dead. This has integrated graphics, so maybe if we just bypass a discrete card altogether, we can get a post. Maybe. I would also like to note that throughout this entire process, our 1700X did not get hot at all. I could just touch it straight up, right out of the system, and that's not how it should be. And we're back to the exact same symptom as before. I've given this motherboard enough tries. I really, really thought we could bring it back from the dead with that BIOS update, but we're still getting the same no post, no picture out scenario, and the same Dr. Debug behavior where the CPU light, well, it's not Dr. Debug, but the same LED debug behavior where the CPU light turns on for a few seconds, shuts off immediately, no other debug light pops up, and we just sit here with a black screen. Very odd. Now, I really did not want to do this, and I'm actually running out of B350, 450, 550 motherboards, just because I've had to replace so many on this playlist. I'm gonna swap his board. The only one I have left is a Micro ATX B450. So similar in terms of chipset, but obviously not form factor. It's not the end of the world. He wasn't using the additional PCI slots anyway, but it's just gonna look a bit more tacky than before. But hey, he's getting it for free, so. Come on. So now everything in this platform is the same as what was in his original rig, with the exception of the motherboard. I even put his original CPU back in here, the 1800X, and you can see his original graphics card as well. So the only variable is the board. Let's try powering it on. Wow, that powered on for a split second and then turned off again. How many things are wrong with this system?
I was not going into this expecting to replace the entire system. This does not want to power on either. I can't believe that.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. It's what it looks like. So swapping out his RX 580 here allowed the system to post. I've never seen personally a graphics card cause the system to flicker on and off as quickly as what we saw here. It would literally power on for a split second and then power back off again. The viewers suggested that it was a CPU, but it actually is the graphics card. The other odd thing is, well, why wouldn't the old board post with either of our chips? And even after a BIOS update, we had nothing. I mean, I put, my 5700G in there. Still wasn't working. So it's possible there's some sort of relationship between the graphics card issue and the motherboards, but as of this point, from what I can see here in the office, they're two separate issues, and both would need to be remedied here in order to get the system back up and running again. And I'll be honest with you guys, I don't want to replace the card. At least we know it's bad, but I mean, I'm already replacing the motherboard for him and I'm running low on those as it is. Graphics cards, I haven't restocked because prices are still coming down and I don't want to buy up cards at this point. So this is gonna have to be one of the rare flops. Not that we couldn't figure out what's wrong, but it's just, I'm not willing to put so many components into this to make it work again. I mean, the motherboard and the graphics card are two very important things. And I just don't have the resources right now to replace both for him. He'll have a new motherboard, or a board that works at least, the same chipset family, but he'll need a new graphics card to get the system up and running the way that we have it here. But before we end this one, knowing that the graphics card is the issue, one last thing I want to do is try to get another system, unrelated to his, to power on with this card. I don't want to tell him that this is broken, only, you know, for it to be, I don't know, some issue maybe with the AMD platform. Maybe it works fine with Intel rigs. I'm gonna put this in my personal rig. I don't like doing that with components I suspect are broken because I don't wanna nuke my own system, but I just wanna see if we can replicate the flickering power issue that we saw with his platform.
My system, by the way, obviously works. It was working a few seconds ago. Just swapped the card out. Single 8-pin, it looks awkward because these are bridged PCIe cables. But anyway, we're gonna power the system back on. That's cool. So the motherboard LEDs are lit. Let's see what happens. Yeah. Same problem. The power just flickers on and off for a split second. We don't get LEDs in this board like we were before, but I mean, it powers on and off so quickly, it probably just doesn't register. Yeah, it does not like it. We try the start button up here. Nothing. So this card is frickin' toast.
The Corsair HS65 surround gaming headset delivers all-day comfort and sound with memory foam leatherette ear pads, lightweight aluminum reinforced construction, and Dolby Audio 7.1 surround on both Mac and PC. You can even use IQ software with Sound ID to customize audio profiles for unique experiences in-game and in chat. As always, you can learn more by clicking the link below.
Well, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but yep. A flop for the books, and like again, it's not because we couldn't figure out what was wrong. In fact, there are two things wrong with this rig, and I just don't want to give two things. I'm used to giving one upgrade, one swap, you know, just something that they can, you know, something to get them back up and running again. It needs a bit too much, so yeah, we'll leave it at that. If you guys have broken systems, maybe you live in or around Orlando, Florida, and you want a chance to have me fix your rig, if it's maybe not turning on or not posting or what have you, feel free to reach out. We have a link in the description. You can enter your details there and submit a form. We'll get back to you at the earliest convenience, and we'll let you know if you're accepted or rejected just based on the symptoms you describe and whether or not we have hardware to replace what might be broken in your rig. Thumbs up, subscribe, leave a comment down below, and yeah, catch you in the next one. Sorry for being so, you know, unenthusiastic at this point. But, yeah. Thanks for watching. My name's Greg. Thanks for learning with me.